Everyone, get ready to listen and to hear what Ibrahim ibn Adham has said with regards to why our dua is not being accepted. Subhanallah, Ibrahim ibn Adham has said, لِأَنَّ قُلُوبَكُمْ مَاتَتْ بِعَشْرَةِ أَشْيَاءِ. He said, the reason Allah doesn't answer your dua, let me tell you, it's for 10 reasons. Because your hearts have gone dead for 10 reasons. And he's going to tell us one after the other. And he said, number one, عَرَفْتُمُ اللَّهِ وَلَمْ تَأَدُّوا حَقَّ. He said, you have come to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know who Allah is, but you do not fulfill His rights. Isn't that true? We know Allah, but we don't do what He tells us to do. Number two, he said, وَقَرَأْتُمُ الْقُرْآنَ وَلَمْ تَعْمَلُوا بِهِ. He said, you recite the Quran day and night, but none of you practices the Quran. That's number two. And number three, he said, وَزَعَمْتُمْ حُبَّ نَبِيِّكُمْ وَتَرَكْتُمْ سُنَّتَهُ. You claim to love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but you never follow his sunnah. How true is it? وَزَعَمْتُمْ حُبَّ نَبِيِّكُمْ وَتَرَكْتُمْ سُنَّتَهُ. And he said number four, وَقُلْتُمْ إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌ وَوَافَقْتُمُ. You said that shaitan is our enemy, but you always agree with him. How is that possible? He said, always you say shaitan is our enemy, we hate Iblis, but you always agree with him, you follow his ways. And let me tell you number five. Number five, وَقُلْتُمْ إِنَّكُمْ مُشْتَاقُونَ إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ وَلَمْ تَعْمَلُوا لَهَا. You always say that we love Jannah, we crave for Jannah, we all want to go to Jannah, but you don't really act as if you want to go to Jannah. Isn't that true? And the next one, he said, وَقُلْتُمْ إِنَّكُمْ تَخَافُونَ النَّارِ وَلَمْ تَهْرُبُوا مِنْهَا. You always say that you are fearful of hellfire, or we're scared of hell, but you never run away from hellfire. Rather, you are running towards hellfire. Isn't that what we do day and night? And look what else he said. Subhanallah. وَقُلْتُمْ إِنَّ الْمَوْتَ حَقِّ. You say, he said, you say that death is inevitable. It will definitely come, but you are not ready to die. You don't prepare yourself for death. After our khutbah today, we have a janazah. A janazah for whom? Someone who's just like us. A brother called Abdullah. Abdullah Ilm. He was a worshipper in this very masjid. Part of the congregation. A regular attendee of the masjid. Helps out the people. Learn the Quran. And he just died. Unexpected. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us a time is going to come when death will happen very frequently and people will die just like that, without any illnesses, without any accidents, just you will just die. Subhanallah. Isn't it something that is happening now that we see all the time? And also the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or Ibrahim ibn Adham, he also said, وَاشْتَغَلْتُمْ بِعُيُوبِ النَّاسِ. Please listen to this. وَاشْتَغَلْتُمْ بِعُيُوبِ النَّاسِ وَتَرَكْتُمْ عُيُوبَكُمْ. This is another reason he said why Allah doesn't accept your dua. He said, you have busied yourself, you have preoccupied yourself with the shortcomings of other people, and you have forgotten your own problems. How true is it? You tell me. We are always busy with the faults of other people. We always criticize others. Don't speak to this person. Don't go to this place. This person is evil. That person is evil. How good are you? Are you an angel? It's a question that we need to ask ourselves. He said, you have become busy with the faults of other people and you have forgotten your own faults. And then also he said, وَأَكَلْتُمْ نِعَمَ اللَّهِ وَلَمْ تُؤَدُّوا شُكْرَهَا. He said, you are eating from the blessings of Allah. That's exactly. Look how big I am. Day and night, I'm eating from the blessings of Allah. But am I grateful to Allah? That's another thing. You are not thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You don't show your gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're not grateful. And we are not. And I'm number one. And he said, وَدَفَنْتُمْ مَوْتَاكُمْ. And that's, this is something that we're going to do right now. And we've been doing it for a long, long time. وَدَفَنْتُمْ مَوْتَاكُمْ وَلَمْ تَعْتَبِرُوا بِهِمْ فَكَيْفَ يُسْتَجَابُ لَكُمْ. Subhanallah. Very intellectual. Look at the intelligence. He said, you take and you go to the graveyard, to the cemetery, to bury your people. But you don't take any lessons from that. You don't take any heed from it. Look at, he spoke to us, subhanAllah, in a way that we can all understand. Is there anyone that doesn't understand those reasons? How many did you give a tick? I gave all the 10 a tick. I'm suffering from all of them. I don't know how many you are suffering from. This is who we are. SubhanAllah. Because of the janazah, ikhwani, I'm going to shorten the khutbah. But I want you to remember those things. Those 10 things. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.